with a laparotomy that extends all the way to the pubis. The bladder is identified and completely exteriorized from the abdominal cavity and isolated with laparotomy pads. At the apex of the bladder, stay suture is applied full thickness and with traction on the bladder, a stab incision is made on the ventral aspect of the bladder. This stab incision is then enlarged with Metzenbaum scissors. Do not be shy with the size of this cystotomy. It must be large enough to remove all the stones inside and inspect the lumen. Additional stay sutures are placed at the margins of the incision. By manipulating these stay sutures, we can get a good look and feel inside the bladder lumen. In your specimen, there will be some stones that need to be removed. Of course, you may have more than one. You can completely evert the mucosa and check all the creases and crevices of the lumen. Also want to palpate down towards the neck of the bladder. In a male dog, of course, we are going to retrograde and normograde lavage the urethra. Certainly you would want to consider normograde lavaging even in a female specimen that this model is trying to replicate. Using rapidly absorbable monofilament suture size 3 or even 4, a simple continuous pattern is used to close the cystotomy site. Be sure you use a needle that is tapered. We do not want to use a cutting needle. Margins are carefully manipulated with the debakies. Having an assistant maintain a little bit of tension as you take the bites can help maintain appropriate apposition. The closure should not be too tight, but the tissues must be well opposed. We would leak test this closure by retrograde infusion of saline.